Okay, I'm doing a how to survive your first night in Minecraft video here. Okay, naming it YouTube Survival. The seed, I'm going to put Gargamel. Well, actually, I thought of something better. Because I put this for about every world I make, and I love Okay, after you get that, you can just create the new world. Pretty much. First thing when you get in, you want to start gathering wood. Which I mentioned my music was off because it drives me completely crazy. And I'm setting it to easy, which I'd recommend you people do. Yeah, so like I said, I'm going to find some wood because I don't want to have to cut down a bunch of really big trees because it takes forever. So I'm going to start with one of these smaller trees right here. Pretty much, you just don't want to stay out after dark because you will die, most likely. And if you do, it's no big deal, you can just start back over. And you want to get food, like chicken, which I show you right here. But I'd use a weapon to get food. You get however much wood you want, but usually about a half stack to a stack or more is generally good. Okay, so here I am trying to find my way out of the jungle, which is pretty big considering the jungle is multiple chunks. So after I get to this point, I'd turn to the right, I believe, and try to find my way out still. But this jungle is massive on my map, which if you want to play everything I'm doing, just get the seed that I put in the beginning. And follow what I'm doing. But really, surviving isn't copying, it's learning from my mistakes, which I'll make plenty of. Yeah, here I am gathering a flower, which I'm gonna do something with later. And seeds is gonna be something I'm gonna need later. If I want to be able to survive for an extended period of time on something other than meat. Yeah, as you can see right there, there's an ocelot standing over on the bank of the other side. Right there. I noticed it about right now. Too bad I don't have any fish to become Lord of the Cats again. which is kind of an inside joke about another time I played this, and I had an army of cats. It was fun, but... here I am failing to get up on a ledge. Because nothing works out the way you want it to when you're actually recording. Okay, you really don't want to fall that far, because it put me down to 2.5 hearts, which, that's bad when you're trying to survive. And right here, I found a jungle temple, which I'm going to go explore, like an idiot. Because my health is really low, first night, don't have any resources or anything. But, it's for YouTube, so why not? Like I said, learn from my mistakes. Okay. Yeah, be really careful about coming down the stairs from the top. And be careful coming through here because there are traps, which I found out right there. Yeah, don't make all your wood into planks because you can make charcoal out of it, which you can make torches from, which I did not even think about at the time. And now I was like, oh wait, I need charcoal, so... luckily, there was a tree really close to me. I could get 2 pieces from it and make 2 pieces of charcoal. Which I will be showing how to make charcoal in a minute. To make charcoal, you have to have a furnace, which you have to have 8 cobblestone for. Okay, sorry about saying iron. I'm used to playing Take It, where I can make an iron furnace. So, you get the 8 cobblestone, you put it into a crafting bench, and arrange it in a circle. Like this. Okay. You put the furnace down, you put some planks for fuel, I'm cooking chicken first, but then you put the jungle wood on top. And you cook the jungle wood. Or oak wood, spruce wood, it don't really matter, just cook the wood and you will get charcoal from it. You'll get 1 piece per wood you put in. And it takes 1 plank to 1 piece of wood to make charcoal. I made chicken, so I had to put in an extra piece. So all they do is put the charcoal over sticks, and you get torches. You get 4 torches per piece of charcoal and stick. Okay, I'm going down in here to explore, so I'll put a torch down. I see the tripwire right there, so I disable it. I'm looking for more of them, being more cautious. Knocking out some redstone right there. Because you can't be too careful. Another tripwire. Luckily, I was in the way of it. Okay, the saddles can either be used for a pig or for a horse, which is in 1.6.4. If I were you, I would be more careful about just flipping random levers because it could kill you by being a TNT dispenser or a TNT trap. So just don't do that. And how you were actually supposed to do that is you're supposed to pull the first lever to the far wall. Then pull the one closer to you. You pull the first one, then pull the third one, and then you'll find the chest, which I will show you in a minute, because I couldn't find it, so I just dig it up. Because I knew there was something behind here that I would want. If you find diamonds in a chest like this, you're extremely lucky. And I figured I'm just gonna take the chest too, because why not? It's a chest. Gonna need it eventually, so I'm just gonna take it. I come up, I realize it's nighttime. So I decide I'm gonna barricade some of these holes and stay the night here. Okay, there's multiple ways. Well, there's multiple things you can eat if you're hungry. You can eat rotten flesh, which I will end up having to do because I'm down to one heart. And to regenerate health, you have to have full food bar. You can't be missing any, which you'll see right here. Okay, I now have a full food bar, but I'm poisoned, so it's going to heal as fast. I'm just gonna go down and, well, I'm gonna make a better pickaxe right now, but I'm gonna barricade up some dirt so no monsters can kill me. Okay, if you're following along, exactly what I'm doing, mine right here. About as far back as I do. Long as you get in the general direction of where I'm mining, you'll find about the same stuff I do. Which right here, I'm just gathering cobblestone because I'm gonna need it. Because you're pretty much always gonna need cobblestone for something. Okay, right here, I'm digging down, but I'm doing it the smart way, which is going down by stairs. Because if you dig straight down, you have a chance of falling into lava, of course. Or falling into a ravine and killing yourself that way. Which, that's pretty bad. Okay. Right here, I'm going up to get the torch to put it down here. Okay. I don't have a shovel, but if I had a shovel, I'd need to use on the dirt. I should have put the torch back one. But that's no big deal, because torches are infinitely usable. They don't break like everything else. But yeah, so right here I'm just digging the dirt with my hand, which it don't take too long. But with a shovel it'd be faster, and I found some coal. Which I always recommend getting coal when you find it. You won't always see me do it, but you really need to get it. And right here I make some more torches because I can do it in my inventory. Which that is a really good tip for you guys. Always bring some wood with you when you go mining so you can make torches in case of an emergency. Bring planks and just raw wood in case you need to make charcoal. Because if you're mining, chances are you will have enough raw wood to make a crafting table and have a little bit of charcoal. Or at least just bring about 10 raw wood with you. That'd be a really smart thing to do. Okay, I'm just getting rid of that, so I don't have to worry about anything. Right here, I'm making another cobblestone axe. I'll put another torch here, so no monsters will spawn, because they spawn in anything under, like, a 7 light rating, which means one torch every 7 blocks, I think. Okay, here I continue digging down, and if you dig down far enough, you'll either hit bedrock, or you can find a cave system. Which I'm trying to get down to level 12, because on level 12 you have a greater chance of finding diamonds than anywhere else. Which you can check that by pressing F3, which I will show you here in a minute. Okay, so okay, I'm close to some skeletons because that's what that sound is right there. Which I will not go up to the skeletons because I don't have any sort of weapon right now at this point. I did. And I had a diamond sword and at least iron armor, I'd go for it normally. There you go. So right here, I push F3, and your depth is the Y. So I'm at level 50 right now. So I'm a long way off from 12. So I'm just gonna continue going down until I get 12 or hit a cave. Making sure I don't have any iron. Oh, and look what I was here, a cave. Am I gonna build that hole back in? Because I'm gonna want to continue to go down, but I'm gonna go check this cave out. Which, if you go cave exploring, you really need to have a weapon on you in case of monsters like that. Yeah, I know I'm an idiot for not doing what I'm telling you guys to do, but learn from my mistake. Take a weapon with you. I'm making a diamond sword because I have enough for a sword, and a diamond sword is always a good investment for your diamonds. Okay, right here I'm making a gold pickaxe because gold works faster than diamond pickaxes, but you can't mine anything like iron, gold, or any resource with them. You can only mine cobblestone with them. Okay, I gotta look for the skeleton. He's not there. He ends up being behind me. Okay, that's iron to my left that I just walked by. Okay, here's what happens if you mine iron with a gold pick. You don't get it. You can mine iron with a stone, however, but you can't mine anything else. Any other metal ores like gold. Well, you can only mine cobblestone with gold. You can't mine cobblestone or gold or diamond with it, or redstone, I think. You might be able to do redstone. But a creeper's a two-hit with a diamond sword. That's why I just did that right there. Okay, there's another skeleton right there. Okay, don't run at him like that because you'll knock him away and you will die like that. So, here's how to survive. Just don't do what I did right there. Okay. Thanks for watching.